this has been our first virtual listing, which has got a lot of airtime in terms of how people have been resilient through COVID. So I think more than just listings, what we've seen at the exchange is in these tumultuous markets, in really volatile markets, and with the whole ecosystem really working from home, whether it's from a listed space or a trading segment, we've seen real resilience come through in the South African capital markets. And the virtual listing is just testament to one of such innovation and such resilience to say that you still have the wheels of momentum keeping at bay and continuing, and bringing product to market in such innovative ways is really creative. So just to highlight, Bronwyn, it's not particular that any merits of the listings itself has been different. So that process has been pretty much status quo. But where we normally have a launch event of the actual listing to mark the listing on the JSE, we have done that now through a virtual listing medium so that we could celebrate such a milestone listing.
Did you have a number of people embracing and celebrating the listing with you?
Yes, you know, I think really I've been pleasantly surprised at how much traction this has got, because the feel-good sentiment has been really, you know, that we can still show product innovation coming through the form of Satrix now listing their second bond ETF for their suite, and also to mark a virtual listing. So it really, really brought the ecosystem together. Their event culminated in two things that were quite symbolic. One is we've had our security guards who've been on site on the premises still actually carry out some of the traditions. You would know in South Africa, we sound the opening of the market through the blowing of the kudu horn or beating of the drums, where other exchanges typically ring the bell. And that was still carried out in person at our offices to really mark, you know, that there's some tradition that we can keep the same, but carried out or executed by our brave security guards who are keeping the lights on at the building. So that was really one feel-good factor that really embodies how in different markets, everybody comes together. And then the Satrix event itself also ended the event with the national anthem being sung by many, many participants who had subscribed to the listing, whether it was their end investors, their ecosystem of participants who would become market makers or clients in this product. So that was two things for me that really showed the feel-good factor of such a listing.
And then just finally, the success of the listing, obviously Satrix's second bond ETF.
So South Africa in general has had a focus towards passive investing and ETF investing in particular. We still have a long way to grow in terms of catching up to the global space. But the success of this listing, I think, is that one, it adds another type of asset class that, or product, should I say, that an investor can invest in. The markets have been really, really tough this first quarter, notwithstanding COVID volatility, but other related market volatility. So any product that shows diversity to the end client, which has also shown more interest to invest in the markets now that some of the equities and bonds products have taken quite a beating, you know, they provide different alternatives or appeal at the moment. So we hope that this listing is successful. The ETF space in South Africa has been quite shown phenomenal growth over the past 2 to 3 years. We have 74 ETFs now listed at the JSE, and they span a whole host of equity, bond, local and global debt, platinum ETFs and gold ETFs are really in the precious metal space, where people have been looking for safe haven places to hide in the current volatility. We've seen the precious metal ETFs really outperform. We've seen the value traded really upbeat in the first quarter on the back of all this high volume and value traded that we've seen it through in the ETF space. So I'm sure this listing would be but one success in the whole ETF space that we've seen in South Africa, and provide valuable alternatives for the investors.